to Emergence. What are you going to be able to tell us about it?
We know what the mystery is. I think that was a big, I think when you do a show like this, that's sort of a thriller that has a mystery. We wanted to make sure there was a mystery that could sustain for several seasons, could keep surprising you, could be something that you don't figure out within the first 5 seconds, but also not something that you have to hold back on. I think people get really bored. I know I do. If I feel like a show is not telling you what's going on, you start to feel like they don't really know what's going on. So we're going to explain things quickly, or at least some of them.
And hopefully keep developing the idea into new mysteries and kind of, but there's surprises along the way.
How many seasons do you guys have it?
For sure,
three,
and then the end of the third season sort of launches you into even a whole different kind of story.
Being women creators, and how important was it for you to have a female as your lead?
You know what? This idea always centered around a strong female protagonist. I mean, we've done plenty of shows where we've had male leads, and but for whatever reason, this idea specifically, we wanted to tell a story about a mother, someone who is also professional and is working, and that's something we deal with always, being a working mom as well, and seeing that portrayed as a strong
character. That being said, our last show, Jason Ritter was the lead.
Yeah.
So I think that it wasn't like, oh, we have to write a female lead show. It's just how this sort of developed.
It depends on the idea. Because we also wrote Agent Carter, and, you know, so we've enjoyed writing anyone from the
So what's the jumping in point, really, for the audience? What is the teaser you're going to hook them with in order to say this is the show they want to watch it?
What do you mean the jumping in point?
Well, from what we've seen so far, which is not much because we've seen trailers.
Okay.
We know there's, of course, somebody who helps a child, and there's probably people trying to come after the child.
Yes.
There's a large-scale emergency event that happens that basically sucks our lead character, Joe, into the story. And sort of, I think it kind of catapults her into sort of the mystery right away. And so I think that people will be drawn in because it's also it's a mystery, it's a thriller, and it's a family show. And so I think that the relationships that you see develop even within the pilot is something that draws you in as much as the sort of thriller mystery.
And I think you don't have to be a family show fan only to appreciate it, and you don't have to be a sci-fi fan. I think that it hits a lot of different genres, that there's something for a lot of different people.
That's something we've always loved doing, is mixing genres.
What inspired you guys for this show?
Very much sort of tonally like Spielberg from when we were growing up, so Close Encounters, E.T. If you've seen Close Encounters recently, there's some legitimately like scary moments in that, but it's also about wonder. And then just the story of finding a kid, and it's somewhat based on a true story about somebody that my husband worked with, where there was a cop in the 60s or 70s who found a little kid at a crime scene and basically just took the kid home and adopted her and raised her, which seems like, it's like, oh, 1970s, I guess you could do that then. But like, so I sort of, you hear a story like that and you're immediately like, oh, I really like this person. And what I love about someone who does that is there was no sort of thinking about it, like, should I do this? Should I know this? She just instantly was like, oh, this is the right thing to do, so let's just do that. And I love that as a character. I love that it's a real person. But I thought that was a nice way to sort of click into Allison's character right away.
Can you tell us a little more about the casting process? So did you have anyone in mind when you were writing
this? This time, when we first wrote it, it's not, sometimes you'll do that. It's like, oh, and this character is George Clooney, but you know you're never going to get George Clooney, but it's like that sort of the.
And I didn't have Alice because I had watched Frozen. And I'm like, I love how down to earth she is, how I think people really engage with her. She's great at humor. She can do anything. And, you know, so it was.
We met with her.
Yes.
And the first thing she said was, am I going to have to wear a uniform? And we said, no. You're the captain. You can wear whatever you want. She's like, great. we sort of clicked right away. The other thing she really liked is the way that mothers are sometimes portrayed on TV is like someone who gives their entire life to their child and sort of lives vicariously for her child, which is not our mothers, not how we are as mothers, and that, you know, that. And we didn't ever want to write a character who's just like constantly like petting this little girl. It's like, no, she sort of absorbs her into the family as a matter of practicality more than anything else. And so she really clicked into that too. That it's like being a mom was a facet of her life, but it wasn't the only defining thing of the. I think Allison probably got a lot of roles that the only defining characteristic was she was a mom. And it's like, no one is that. No one has that as one defining characteristic. So I think she can speak better to that, but I think she liked that as well. And then Donald Faison was a nice surprise. I think you sort of think you know him because you've seen him in Scrubs. And what's crazy is if you go out with Donald Faison, everyone thinks they know him. I've never been in New York. You just are walking down the streets and people lose their marbles. And he's so kind about it. But it's like people feel like they know him and they're friends. And he's so kind. He always takes a picture. And but when he came in for an audition, you sort of think, oh, he's the guy from Scrubs. I don't think he's right for this role. Because you just think you know him. And then in under 10 minutes of auditioning, we're like, oh, he just got the job. Like, right, like, he walked out and everyone was like, that's the, I mean, so what I love that in that short amount of time, he changed everyone's minds. It's not even we didn't like him. It's just like, no, that's not right. But it's like, oh, no.
You realize he's only, no, do we have to get up?
Yes.
Donald's going to be so upset.